Hey buddy, in the previous video, I have talked about a few points on why command line applications are better than graphical ones. In this video, we will see how to use command line applications. Command line applications are programs that don't have a graphical user interface where one cannot interact with menus, buttons, and windows. To interact with the command line application, one has to type some text into a terminal emulator or a TTY, which means teletype terminal. A user can pass certain flags, options, and arguments specific to the command by typing them after the command in the same line. The flags, options, and arguments decide how the application gets executed. A flag, which is also sometimes referred as a switch, is a true or false value. When the flag is passed to the application, the value becomes true, and when it is not, the value is false. The command line flag will have two dashes before the flag name or a single dash when given in its short form. For example, I will be using one of my own projects named Samaya. When given the dash dash verbose flag, the application outputs more information than the default. To use the verbose flag in short form, we use a single dash and the short version of the flag, which in this case is V. Just like a flag, an option will also start with two dashes followed by the name of the option. But options require additional data after typing the option separated by a space. For example, here I'm setting the time zone option with dash dash time zone followed by a time zone text. Basically, a set of flag followed by some additional data is known as an option. The user data that is not prefixed with a flag is called an argument. Some command line programs expect that you provide arguments at certain predefined positions. For example, the rm command, which deletes a file or directory, expects that the user provides an argument of what to delete. In case the user does not, the application errors out. Once the application is started, there are three streams by which the user can receive or send data. While we talk about those, here are a few commands I use in my daily workflow. The first stream is standard error. This is where the application prints out error messages. This stream is also called as stderr. On a Unix-like operating system like macOS, Linux, or BSD, the standard error stream is stored with the variable number 2 until the application is running. The second stream is standard output or stdout, through which the application prints everything that is not an error. The standard output stream is stored under the variable number 1. Both standard output and standard error are for the application to print information to the user. When a user enters some data while the application is running, the data goes through the third stream, which is standard input or stdin. Here is an example I have made to demonstrate the two streams. This is a simple C++ program that outputs data into both stderr and stdout streams. In the first case, when we suppress the stdout stream, we only see the error messages and not the common output that is printed by the application. When we suppress the stderr stream instead, all the error messages are suppressed except the application output. Here is another program that I have made to demonstrate the standard input stream. When the application is ready to receive the user input, it waits for the user to enter the required data and then proceeds with the execution. Instead of manually entering the data to a command line application, we can pass one application's stdout or stderr to another application as stdin. This is done in the following way. Now that we have a basic idea of how command line applications work, let's see how to check the version of any command line application. To check the version of a command line application, we simply pass the version flag like this. Or for more complex command line applications, we may also need to run the version command, which we may be covering in the near future. Lastly, to check what all flags, options, and arguments you can give to a command, pass the help flag and it will print out a list of what can be used with that specific application. So that was it for this video. Please subscribe and hit the bell icon for more videos like this. This is Vasant Developer, signing off.